In this section, we're shifting our attention to the candidate dashboard. And three key concepts you'll learn are how to create state lists to enable checkmark functionality, how to upload files so that candidates can upload their CVs and apply to jobs. And we'll also be creating a new data type called application and looking at how all of our data types relate and connect to one another. Let's dive in and take a look at the demo. So this is the candidate dashboard. After logging in, this gentleman called Peter, he will be routed with a bit of logic on the signup page to his candidate dashboard. In the first tab we have is account, and we can see that this is designed slightly differently. We have this dark sidebar. We also have the workplace logo up here because it's not a company. So it's just a user of the application or a candidate. So we can get our branding back in. And on the first tab account, the design is very similar to the company page, of which we will be cloning, okay? So part of my design process is that I tend to make a lot of reusable elements, some of them with functionality, some of them just so that I can detach it and then maintain some of the design work that I've done. We will be cloning the company page so that we can retain the design work that we've done. And we'll be going through a refactoring process, which is much faster and easier. And it just makes sure that our designs are coherent, right? So we don't start, if we had to do this again, maybe the floating group menu would be slightly wider because we're too lazy to have a look at the company page, what we did. So as you can see, we may as well just clone it. Everything is baked in, looking good, and it's a good starting point. We've got really far ahead already, okay? So yeah, so you recognize this form. And then on the right-hand side, we have some checkbox functionality. So when I talked about state lists, this is what I meant. Once we've made our selections, then we can go ahead and save that back to Peter's user record. Then on the applications, we have our job applications. And this is where it gets interesting, because we'll head across to the job page in a second to look at how this is done. But as Peter has applied to two jobs, we can see the company logo, name, job title, and all the other data that's important to us. And we can also see the status. So just something to note here is that we have, for instance, a status field that's pending. We're not going to be building in all of the functionality for a fully fledged jobs board. That's for you to carry on with after this course. We just don't have enough time. That would be many, many months to get through. And I've worked at a company that is a nationwide jobs board, so I know what's involved. But this is the framework for it, and we're going to get far enough for you to be able to continue if you like. But this is also an educational experience. So a lot of this is conceptual stuff that I'm trying to teach you that applies to all the different apps that you will be building. For instance, state lists. That's something that you'll be building in all of your apps. Privacy, data structure, responsive design. It doesn't actually matter that we're building a jobs board here, but if you did want to continue on the jobs board, then I'm giving you some hints about certain functionality that you probably do need, okay? Then we have a link to be able to go and look at that job. But if we do go to jobs, here is a job that I've already applied for. And here is some logic to say that, hey, you've already applied for this job, okay? If I go to browse jobs, and obviously I haven't filled out all of the data on all of these jobs. If I go to, instance, to this job here, and I hit apply now, we've got this pop-up. If I type in this box, that would be a cover letter. We've got upload CV. If I click that, then we've got a file uploader where I can upload my PDF. We will get a progress bar showing the status or the progress of that upload, and then we can submit the application. And there's some very cool stuff we're doing here around making sure that this file is private, secured on the server, and that only the user who uploaded the file has access to it, or the company representative such as Hannah from Orbit. She will also have access and no one else will. Okay, so building some really cool stuff here, a lot of conceptual, some new conceptual stuff, and let's get to it. I'll see you in the next lesson.